In this lesson, we're going to look at calculating pH values from H plus concentrations, as well as POH and OH minus. And we're going to learn how to convert between those values. So pH is just another way of showing the H plus concentration. So we've looked at how to calculate molarity, and we can find the concentration of H plus in molarity of a solution. pH is just a different way to report it, and it's often easier since the numbers for the H plus concentration are typically very low. And what we look at when we look at our pH scale is we see that pH goes from roughly 0 up to 14. There are some things that fall outside of that, but most of the solutions we will look at will fall within that range. Anything below 7 is considered acidic. Anything above 7 is considered a base. And so when we look at that neutral territory in the middle, what we see is that it's around 7, but there might be some slight variation. So blood has a pH of 7.4. It's just very slightly basic. And it's not nearly as basic as, say, liquid drain cleaner, which has a pH of 14. So again, like many other things, it's a relative scale. Coffee is slightly acidic. Grapefruit juice or lemon juice are more acidic. You do not need to remember specific pH values for substances, but you should know the scale from 0 to 14 and what is considered acidic, neutral, or basic. So in just a second, we're going to look at how we actually calculate pH values and how we use our calculator to do that. This chart kind of shows you a rough guideline. And just to show you a quick way to assess, is your pH value an appropriate or reasonable answer? So notice if we have 1.0 times 10 to the 0, our pH is 0. We have 1.0 times 10 to the minus 2, our pH is 2. Minus 4, 4, minus 6, 6, minus 8, 8, and so on. Now, if the value is not 1 times 10 to the minus 6, it's not going to be exactly 6, but we know it's going to be somewhere in that range. So this is just a helpful tool to help you learn whether or not an answer is reasonable or not. Now we're going to look at how we calculate pH from the H plus concentration and how we calculate the H plus concentration given the pH value. And the important thing is that you learn how to do this on the calculator that you will use on the exam. So it's one thing to be able to do it on your graphing calculator on your phone, but make sure you practice this with the calculator you will use on the exam. Now the Sigfig rules for pH values are a little bit different than what we've seen previously. So our H3O plus concentration, which remember is the same as our H plus concentration, those are used interchangeably. When we look at our concentration, we see it's 3.5 times 10 to the minus 3. So two things we can see here. One, it's 10 to the minus 3, so we know our pH has to be somewhat near 3, so this is a reasonable answer. But when I see two sig figs in my concentration, I have two decimal places in the pH value. So the concentration has the number of sig figs equal to the number of decimal places in the pH. So let's look at an example. What is the pH of a solution whose H plus concentration equals 3.2 times 10 to the minus 3? Now you see that there's only one possible answer, so you know that's the correct answer. But I want you to try this on your calculator and make sure you can get to that answer before you click in. So we're going to talk about two different methods, and one of these two usually covers most calculators. The first is for the calculator that I recommended, the TI-30X2S. This is the method you'll use. So when you want to find pH, you'll use your negative sign, then you'll hit the log button. Make sure there's an log log and an ln, which is natural log. We want to use the log button. And then you'll type in your concentration, which is 3.2 times 10 to the minus 3. Make sure you're using your scientific notation correctly. 3.2, you'll hit the EE button, negative 3. And then you hit enter, and that will give you the pH value. Some calculators, if you have the other version of the TI-30 calculator, you actually have to enter things a little bit differently. First, you type in the H3O plus concentration, again using scientific notation as appropriate. Then you hit the log button, and then you hit the negative sign. Your calculator may be different, and if you need help with that, please do not hesitate to ask. Now that we know how to get from the H plus concentration to the pH, we need to look at the reverse. How do we get from pH to H plus? And so when we look at the equation that we know is for the concentration to pH value, which is given here at the top, pH equals negative log of H plus, I need to rearrange this equation to solve for the H plus concentration. So the first thing I do is I divide both sides by a negative 1, so that moves my negative sign to the left over with negative pH equals log of H plus. And then I take both sides to the power of 10. So I have 10 to the minus pH and 10 to the log of H plus. So 10 to the log are actually opposite functions. It's sort of like if I take 2 times x and divide by at 2, I cancel out those 2s. So 10 and log are opposite functions. So multiply and divide are opposite, plus and minus are opposite functions, 10 and log are opposite functions. So what I end up with is 10 to the minus pH equals the H plus concentration. Now, another one for you to try. What is the H plus concentration of a solution with a pH equal to 8.42? Again, only one correct answer, so you know you're going to get it right, but you need to make sure you do this on your calculator first. So we're trying to solve for the H plus, which is equivalent to the H3O plus. And so the TI-30X2S, you'll type second log, the negative sign, and then the pH value, and then hit enter. For some calculators, you need to type in 10, so 1, 0, use the caret for the power, negative the pH value. On other calculators, you need to type in the pH value, then the negative sign, then hit second log. Remember, you need to make sure you're using the log button, the LOG log, and not the LN natural log. So once you've figured that out and gotten the answer, you want to click in. It should be 3.8 times 10 to the minus 9th. So all of the problems we looked at here were dealing with pH and H plus concentrations. However, we can use the same expression with other variables. So we have pH equals the negative log of H plus. We can also have pOH equals the negative log of OH minus. And what we'll see later when we look at the strength of acids and bases, we'll talk about pKa, but again, it equals negative log of Ka. So anytime I put the P in front of a value, it simply means take the negative log of that number. So I can take P of my shoe size, and it would be negative log of my shoe size. So P means just take the negative log of a number. Now, we have pH and pOH, H plus and OH minus. There actually is a way to make a link between these two. This is true at 25 degrees Celsius, but that's all we're going to be worrying about. But what we know is that pH plus pOH equals 14. So we can actually convert from OH minus concentration to pOH, get to pH, and then get to our H plus concentration. So this equation, pH plus pOH equals 14, gets us back and forth between pH and pOH.